हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। टुडे इज 23rd जनवरी 2021। योर चैप्टर 10 इंटरनेशनल बिजनेस वॉज गोइंग ऑन। स्टूडेंट्स, इन द लास्ट क्लास आई हैव स्टार्टेड प्रोसीजर्स फॉर एक्सपोर्ट ट्रेड। इन दिस आई हैव टॉट टू यू 4 स्टेप्स। नाउ आई वॉन्ट टू कॉन्टिन्यू इट फ्रॉम द नेक्स्ट स्टेप, दैट इज रिलेट फ्रॉम द ऑब्टेनिंग प्री शिपमेंट फाइनेंस। इन द प्रीवियस क्लास आई हैव ऑलरेडी टॉट यू अबाउट द receipt of inquiry, then after that sending quotation, then second step is receipt of order or indent, third is relates from the assessing importer's credit worthiness and securing a guarantee for payment, and the fourth point was obtaining export license. So after the obtaining export license, the next is relates from the obtaining pre-shipment finance. So fifth point is obtaining pre-shipment finance. Pre-shipment finance. Listen, students. After receiving the letter of credit, I have already taught you about the letter of credit. Letter of credit is what? Letter of credit is considered as the most appropriate method to secure payment in international transactions. Okay. So after receiving the letter of credit, the exporter approaches his banker for pre-shipment finance. Exporter approaches his banker, it means in where the exporter has their bank account, then that exporter approaches his banker to pre-shipment finance. Pre-shipment finance is the finance that the exporter needs for procuring raw materials and other components. It means before exporting any type of the goods, when the exporter want to export the goods, so before exporting the goods, the exporter has been required the procuring raw material and other components, processing and packaging of goods, and transportation of goods to the port of shipment. So it means it has been required from the pre-shipment of the delivery of the goods, that is related from the pre-shipment of finance. Okay, clear? Now next point is, next procedure is relates on the production or procurement of goods. Sixth point is production or procurement of goods. Okay, listen. After getting the pre-shipment finance, the exporter starts manufacturing the goods. It means when the some amount has been received with the help of the banker, with the help of the banker from the importer, then the exporter start manufacturing that goods as per the order that has been received from the importer. In case the exporter is not a manufacturer, then he procures the goods from the market. It means if the goods has been produced by the manufacturer, so and that manufacturer is related from the exporter, so that goods has been also produced by that exporter. Or if that is not related from any type of the productions work, that is not related from the any type of the manufacturing work, so then the exporter procures the goods from the market. The goods so produced or procured should conform to the specifications given in the export order. It means that is based on the export order, and it has been provided the confirmation regarding the exporting of the goods. So that will be relates on the sixth point. Next point is relates on the pre-shipment inspection. Next step is pre-shipment inspection. Listen about it. In order to ensure that only goods quality product are exported, okay, the Indian government has passed Export Quality Control and Inspection Act 1963. It means before the shipment of the goods that will be exported to any other country, there is the specific act that has been passed by the Indian government. That act is relates from the Export Quality Control and Inspection Act 1963. Okay, its aim is to make compulsory inspection of certain category of products If goods fall under this category, then exporter applies to export inspection agency. It means on the basis of that type of the inspection, it has been checked, the goods has been released from the proper quality or as the requirement of the importer, the goods has been exported or not. Second thing, if the goods conform to the prescribed specification, an inspection certificate is issued. It means after inspecting the goods as per the prescribed specification that has been also provided by the exporter to importer. So after that, the inspection certificate has been also issued. This certificate is to be submitted along with other export documents at the time of the exports. Okay, it means when the goods has been exported, then with the other documents, that certificate, that inspection certificate that has been also export, that has been also submitted along with the export documents. Okay, remember one thing more, inspection is not compulsory for some types of the houses, for some types of the exporters, as like I want to tell here some example regarding it, as like star trading houses, second trading houses, export houses, industrial units set up in export processing zones or special economic zone, or 100% export oriented units. So on the basis of that type of the thing, here the inspection is not necessary. Okay, for such type of the agencies, for such type of the exporters, remember it. Okay, so that is relates on the pre-shipment inspection. Products having ISI certification mark or AG mark are not required to be inspected by any agency. Okay, it means that type of thing is based on the any type of the goods that has been exported. It means even the ISI certification marks or AG mark has been allotted on any type of the product, so at that time there is no requirement of any type of the inspection of that type of the exported goods. Clear? Next thing is relates on the excise clearance. Next step procedure hamara kya hai? Next, excise clearance. 8th, excise clearance. Listen, according to Central Excise Tariff Act, exporter is required to pay excise duty on certain excisable goods and to obtain excise clearance certificate. Okay, it means there is the requirement of payment of any type of the duty that is based on the excise duty. It is related from the excise clearance certificate. Okay, for the certificate, he has or she has to apply to the concerned excise commissioner with an invoice. For that type of the clearance certificate, for that type of the excise duty, there is the requirement of any type of the invoice relates from excise commissioner, from the excise commissioner who has been concerned relates from the exporting of such type of the material. When the commissioner is satisfied, then that commissioner has issued the excise clearance. That means after paying the excise duty, after all the documents, when he has been, he or she has been satisfied for that type of the clearance, for that type of the documents also, so then that commissioner has issued the excise clearance certificate. However, in many cases, exported goods are exempted from the excise duty. Because when the goods has been exported, if there is so many charges or excise duty has been charged, so it will be related from the costly process, the cost price of that type of the goods, the selling price that type of the goods related from the exporter will be increased. So in many cases, exported goods are exempted from the excise duty. It means no excise duties has been charged on many types of the products. If the duty is already paid, then it is refunded back to the exporter in order to make export products more competitive. ओके okay, अगर आपकी ऑलरेडी क्या हो गई है, एक्साइज ड्यूटी पेमेंट हो गई है, देन इट विल बी रिफंडेड बैक टू द एक्सपोर्टर. वो क्या होगी, एक्सपोर्टर को रिफंड कर दी जाएगी इन ऑर्डर टू मेक एक्सपोर्ट प्रोडक्ट्स मोर कॉम्पिटिटिव. हमारे एक्सपोर्ट प्रोडक्ट को क्या कॉम्पिटिटिव बनाने के लिए. इट मीन्स इफ द गुड्स हैज बीन मोर कॉस्टली देन इन द मार्केट, द एक्सपोर्टर विल नॉट सर्वाइव, विल नॉट एक्सपोर्ट द गुड्स टू एनी अदर कंट्रीज. सो एट दैट टाइम the amount of the export duty has been also refunded. Such refund of duty is known as duty drawback. Jo refund hoti hai aapki excise duty, that type of the duty is called duty drawback. For the refund, the exporter has to apply to the commissioner of customs or central excise duty. It means for the refunding amount of that type of the export duty that has been already paid by the exporter to the excise duty commissioner, so it has been filled a specific form relates from the refund of the excise duty. Clear? So that procedure is relates from the excise clearance. Now next ninth point is based on the obtaining certificate of origin. Ninth point, obtaining certificate of origin. Listen, some importing countries provide tariff concessions or other exemptions to the goods coming from a particular country. It means there is any type of the exemptions has been also provided by the importer countries, because when the goods has been exported by the exporter to any other country, so when the goods has been imported to any other country, so there is some tariff concessions has been also provided or some exemptions has been also provided from a particular country. In order to such benefits, the importer may ask the exporter to send a certificate of origin. It means where the goods has been produced, where the goods has been manufactured. So on the basis of that type of the exemptions, the importer country has been also required the certificate of origin. This certificate testifies the origin of goods exported. It can be obtained from the trade consulate located in the exporter's country. It means that type of the goods has been produced, that type of the goods has been originated in which country, that certificate has been also provided by the trade consulate located in the exporter's country. So that type of the certificate, that type of the origin of certificate is beneficial for the exemptions of different types of the taxes that has been charged by the importer countries at the time of the importing of goods. Okay, so it is based on your ninth point. Now 10th procedure is reservation of shipping space. 10th is a reservation of shipping space. Listen about it. The exporting firm applies to the shipping company for the reservation of shipping space. It means next step is based on the reservation for space that goods has been shipped for the exporting. So at that time, the exporter has applies for the reservation of the shipping space. So he or she has to provide complete details regarding type of goods, expected date of shipment and port of destination. So each and every type of the points, each and every type of the detail, it is mentioned at for the time of the reservation of shipping space. Okay, second thing is, on accepting the application, the shipping company issues a shipping order. When the application has been accepted, so the shipping company issues a shipping order. It means that is sure that type of the goods has been reserved for the shipping. Next thing is, shipping order is an instruction. It relates on the instruction to the captain of the ship to receive the specified goods on board after clearance from the customs. It means shipping order का एक instruction है जो captain को दिया जाता है ship के through ऑफ द शिप शिप के कैप्टन को दिया जाता है कि दैट स्पेसिफाइड गुड्स ऑन द बोट आफ्टर क्लियरेंस फ्रॉम द कस्टम्स दैट गुड्स हैज बीन शिप्ड. कब शिप हुआ यानी कि ये गुड्स हमारा रिजर्व हुआ है फॉर द पर्पस ऑफ आफ्टर द कंफर्मेशन फ्रॉम द कस्टम्स देयर इज नो प्रॉब्लम ऑफ एनी टाइप ऑफ द गुड्स एट द टाइम ऑफ द शिपमेंट ऑफ एक्सपोर्ट. सो दैट टाइप ऑफ द सर्टिफिकेट हैज बीन प्रोवाइडेड बाय द शिपिंग कंपनी. ओके नाउ नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज पैकिंग एंड फॉरवर्डिंग. 11th पॉइंट पैकिंग एंड फॉरवर्डिंग. लिसन द गुड्स आर देन प्रॉपरली पैक्ड. इट मीन्स आफ्टर रिसीविंग द रिजर्वेशन सर्टिफिकेट आफ्टर रिसीविंग द रिजर्वेशन ऑफ शिपिंग स्पेस द गुड्स आर देन प्रॉपरली पैक्ड एंड मार्क्ड विद नेसेसरी डिटेल्स लाइक नेम एंड एड्रेस ऑफ द इम्पोर्टर because where the goods has been imported. So, name and address of the importer has been provided. Gross and net weight. What is the weight of that type of the material, that type of the exported goods? It has been also provided. Port of shipment and destination, etc. There are the different types of the information that is necessary for the purpose of the exporting of goods. It has been also provided at the time of the packing and forwarding. Then, exporter makes necessary arrangement to transport goods to the port by road or rail. It means how the goods has been exported with the help of the road or rail. In case goods are loaded into a rail wagon, if there is any type of the transport relates on the rail wagon, a railway receipt is issued which serves as a title to the goods. It means railway receipt received hoti hai, then after that it has been also provided the title of the goods. Next thing is relates from here. This receipt is endorsed in favor of the agent to enable him to take the delivery of goods at the port of shipment. It means that is relates from the receipt or that is relates from the delivery of the goods at the port of shipment. So these were relates from the step by step 11 points. In the next class students, there are some points, some procedures, some steps is also pending till now. So in the next class, I will continue it. In the mean duration, students, if you have any doubt, then you can also ask the query with me without any hesitation. Okay? And students, remember, study. If you have any doubt, then you can also ask query. This is the last chapter of your syllabus. So, कहीं कोई doubt होता है, so आप पूछ सकते हैं without any hesitation with me. Okay, but study in a proper way. Okay, students?